In this lesson, we're going to look at what's happening on the molecular level that makes buffers work. We're going to be looking at the reactions that are taking place in that solution that keep the pH fairly constant, okay? See, these are things that we know. This is what the definition of a buffer is, a solution that resists change in pH. We know what it consists of, its recipe. It's a weak acid or base, and it's conjugate, okay? So both of those are in there in significant amounts in that solution, okay? So this is the question. How in the world does that recipe that we're seeing there enable it to resist change to pH? All right, so let's look at this reaction. We've got a buffer, and it tells us what's in that buffer. It's got some acetate ion, the CH3COO minus, that's the conjugate base, and it has the acetic acid, CH3COOH. So I have this buffer, and it contains both of those things, and I want to use this to represent the weak acid, okay, and then I'll let this be its conjugate base, okay, so we have this mixture of the weak base and its conjugate acid in there. And we come and take this solution, so this is all sitting inside of a beaker, and we dump into that solution, what does it say we're putting in there? Some base, all right? So we're going to bring some sodium hydroxide, for example, and we're going to dump that into this solution. Which part of that buffer will the added OH minus react with? Okay, choose one of those. Well, this is a base. Base reacts with acids. So the base will react with the acid form and it will be able to neutralize it, okay? So that is why it will resist change to pH when you add a base, because there's an acid in there to neutralize that base. Well, we can ask a similar question. Let's say that we take this solution and instead of adding a base, we come along and we add some sort of acid to it. When we add an acid to it, we're going to be adding some H pluses to there. When you add H plus in there, that's the acid. What of that buffer is there to neutralize that acid? Well, it would be the base form. Acids get neutralized by bases. So the base form is the CH3COO minus. That is the conjugate base of the weak acid. And that's how they work. Okay, they work by being in solution, both the acid and a base, and are both there to try to neutralize any excess added acid or base that comes into that solution. So we start at the middle picture here. In that middle picture, we see a buffer that contains the solution that contains the buffer. Okay, HA represents the acid form. A minus represents its conjugate base form, and we can see those drawn out in the molecules below. And I have equal amounts of both the weak acid and its conjugate base in that solution. Well, if I come along and I add some base, what am I adding? I'm adding the OH minus. Well, who will the OH minus react with? The HA. And what's happening to the bar? Look at the left side of that image. The bar of the red, the HA, is decreasing because you're using up some of it. And the bar of the A minus is increasing because you're making it. The reaction that's taking place there is that the HA is reacting with the OH minus of the base, and you are ending up doing a proton swap. So this is decreasing during the course of the reaction, and this is increasing during the course of the reaction, and we see that happening in that image. There's still some of both of them in there, and it's still a buffer. The buffer concentration of these two things will change a little bit. So remember our Henderson-Hasselbalch equation where we had that ratio of base over acid? That number is changing a little bit and it's eking it up and down, but it's not changing it drastically. Now on the right hand side, we have added some acid, okay? Maybe some HCl. And those acid ions are going to be neutralized by the base form of that buffer. And it's going to make some HA. So during the course of the reaction, we see that this is going down. Look at the image there. As you go from the center picture to the far right picture, the blue bar is decreasing. It's going down. And the HA is increasing. So these are changing some, but they are not... So, it's affecting that ratio in the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation, eking it up and down as you add an acid and you add a base. So you can imagine that if you're adding a base, it's going to go up some, but it resists change in pH. If you're adding an acid, it's going to go down some, but it resists change. It doesn't change drastically. So that's what we have on the right side after the addition of an acid. So that's what's happening on the molecular level. In order to have a buffer resist change in pH, you've got both the acid and its conjugate base in there. The acid neutralizes bases, the base neutralizes acids, and neutralizing those will help it resist change to pH. Some things to think about. Why can't a strong acid be used? I told you that a buffer has a weak acid in its conjugate base. Why can't it be a strong acid in its conjugate base? Well, let's imagine a strong acid for just a minute. Let's imagine that we try to make a buffer with HCl and its conjugate base salt. There would be a strong acid in its conjugate base. What does this thing do when it goes into solution? It 100% breaks apart into these guys, okay? And we've got some Cl minus. We've got all of this in there, and there's nothing present to neutralize an added acid, okay? Or an added base. Sorry, nothing to neutralize an added acid. This is a conjugate base right there, right? We have this guy right here, we have a base, but it is the conjugate base of this guy, it is so weak that it is neutral. It really isn't basic, okay? So it is not a base. While we give it the title of the conjugate base of this acid, and that is true, it is so weak a base that it is neutral. It cannot pick up a proton. It cannot neutralize any other added acid, and that is why you must have a weak acid and its conjugate base in there, okay? Now, why do they have to be conjugates of each other? Why can't you just take a weak acid and a weak base and dump them into each other and make a solution of that? What do you think an acid and a base, if you dump them together, are going to do? They're going to neutralize each other, okay? They're not going to sit on opposite sides of this equilibrium. Let's write our equilibrium, okay? Let's do an equilibrium with the HF, for example, okay? We had this plus the water in equilibrium with F minus and H3O plus. We make a buffer by adding some of this and some of this, and they sit on opposite sides of the equilibrium aerial. Well, if I took a weak acid and a weak base that weren't conjugates of each other, then they would just get busy neutralizing each other, and they wouldn't be able to set up this nice dynamic equilibrium between them. So that's why you have to have them being conjugates of each other so that they can't react with each other. Okay, so we know how it works. We know what's happening on the molecular level. What we're going to do next is do actual calculations where we're going to take a buffer of some sort, we're going to add an acid to it, or we're going to add a base to it. Oh, that's the acid. We're going to add an acid to it or a base to it, and we're going to calculate the pH of the new solution. Did it not change it at all? Did it change it a little bit? We'll be able to see the numerical values of it resisting change to pH.